Hey guys, it's Melissa. I am thrilled to be able to tell you that Roland has made a game-changing change. They just rolled out VersaWorks for Mac, which means your Roland BN2 or the lowest price print and cut machine, this Roland BN20A, can run on both PC and Mac. This is literally epic. As a Mac girl who has begrudgingly used her PC, I am thrilled for this, and I am so excited to be able to show you how you can install VersaWorks and the Roland DG Connect utility on your Mac. All right, here it goes. So the first thing that you're going to do is go to the Roland software page and enter the machine and model that you're using. Once you do that, it's going to tell you if VersaWorks 7 is available, and as it is here for the Roland BN220 and 20A, you can install VersaWorks 7. So you'll have all of these options here. They all expand. And if you are installing for a Mac, you are obviously going to install this for the first time. And what you're going to do is you're going to see under VersaWorks 7 that there is now a Mac version for the download. So you're going to select that, and then you'll get to this page if you haven't done this already. This is, again, where you are going to install, or where you are going to select your machine. So it's going to tell you, congratulations, you can use it. And then it's going to have a button right below this little graphic, and it's going to say get started. It's going to then ask you a bunch of different questions. This one specifically I did not read. It is about a questionnaire, and I clicked agree and continue, and then got trapped in a questionnaire for about 5 minutes. You're free to do that, or as you can see, they have skip available. These other ones you cannot skip. These are just terms that you need to agree to. Then you are going to get to this download page, and this is where you're going to download the software for either Windows or Mac. So I'm just going to show you, as you can see, Mac, it has the versions that are available. And if you check on your Mac to make sure that you have the correct operating system, you can then move forward with installing. So you'll just click download. It does take, a minute or so for the software to install. And then you can open the installer package. Once you double click that, it literally just walks you through, and you're clicking continue. There is a spot where you need to put in your computer password. So this is the password that you're using, if you have a password on your computer. It's not your VersaWorks or your DG Connect password, okay? And then this one I got a little held up on, but I think I inadvertently clicked allow while I was actually waiting to make sure that I should be doing this, and it worked out. So then I got to this box here, this window here, and this is where mail address. I was like, do I put my street address? It's actually asking for your email. I will tell you that some of the windows and graphics and kind of pop-ups and fields are a little rough. So especially on the Mac version, they don't look like this on the PC. I have it on both now. But what it's asking you for here is your email address. So you're just going to click add your email address in there and then click OK. Once you click next, then it is going to ask you, you'll get another box, and it's going to ask you for your password. Again, this time, this password is the DG Connect password that you're using. So once you have successfully entered your login credentials, you're going to get this screen. And this is another one where it's like stuff's kind of like overlapping each other. I wasn't exactly sure what to do. So what you should do is take the connection cord, which is probably an Ethernet, and plug that into your Mac computer. So I have it into then a USB to UBC or USB-C converter. There's like three different connections together, and I plugged that into my Mac before I continued. You can see it's saying, you know, device not found. Then it pops up and says, oh, we found this connection. Is that correct? And I said allow. Once you do that, you have these two options up here, search from auto or search by IP address. I tried both, and I will tell you that search from auto is what you want. You can see that once it recognizes your connected machine, it does need to be on. So once it once you do that, it will pop up there in the device list. At this point, I am howling. I'm so excited. I'm getting somewhere with this. It does take a minute here, and now here it is. Now you can see what it says here in this screen is loading. So this is another one of those examples where I'm kind of like, what is all of this? So I'm just kind of poking around. What you need to do first though is you're probably going to need to install the firmware update. I will tell you that by clicking the firmware button on this screen, this did not work. I abandoned this completely and ended up just going back to the download area and installing the firmware update for Mac there directly on to my computer as opposed to trying to go through that pop-up window. This did work. I will tell you that when you do this, you're gonna get this pop-up screen, or you'll get the installer and you'll try to install it, and then it's gonna ask you for your IP address. Again, make sure at this point that your computer or that your Roland is powered on and still connected. So it's gonna tell you to turn off the sub power. I will tell you the sub power is the blue button on the front of the machine. It is not the large power button, the main power button on the side. Okay, the side power button needs to remain on. The sub power, the little blue button on the front, is the one that you can turn off or that you need to turn off. I continued to have issues here, and what I saw was that there was a little document in the installer file that said read more. So if you get this message that says it's failed to send the firmware, turn off the your Wi-Fi connection on your computer, just temporarily. And that actually did work for me. So again, you should not need to manually input your IP address here, but it should come up automatically. So once I turned off my Wi-Fi connection, I got the IP address and I turned off the sub power. And again, I just continued on with this and it did actually begin working once the Wi-Fi was off. So you can see that it says it's sending the firmware, and then I got message at the end here that says the installation of the firmware is complete. So at this point, I am just so thrilled. Now, I turn your Wi-Fi back on, and what you can see here is now you still have this like splash screen. And again, it's like, what do you do here? Like, well, there's no settings, what is it? Well, these little teeny icons down at the bottom right under your IP address are what you need to do. So the first thing I would suggest that you install VersaWorks. You can click the VersaWorks icon, the third one there, and then click install. Same thing with the BN2 utility. It is going to pop up and you'll be able to install that right there. You can see like this is great. And again, you can go to the Roland DG Connect website as well. I always sign into both at the same time just to make sure that everything is, you know, okay. And here we've got both. And then again, as I mentioned, you can install VersaWorks from here as well. This takes again like a minute or so to just download the software onto the computer. And then you do need to go through the installation process. So you will find that installation in your downloads folder and work through that, and it will get all set up for you. So at this point, you're like, again, like what even is this? Well, what it is everything you're going to use is right here. It's these three little buttons. Now, one thing that is missing is Flexi Designer, and I have an email or call into Roland to ask about that. But if you open up VersaWorks, you will see that everything is there. And if you get a message that the setup is incomplete, it's likely just because in your utility, you haven't completed the full setup, which is just like loading the media. So once you do that, like you would on a PC, then you now can come back to VersaWorks and see that you are ready to go. So of course I will have other videos on how to use VersaWorks, but this is a game changer.
That wasn't so painful, was it? Believe me, totally, totally worth it to be able to use your Mac to run these if you are a Mac user. If you are a Mac user who also still has a PC, you can use on either, you can install on both, your machine will still operate on both. But I know there's a lot of people out there like me who prefer to use their Mac, they're just more efficient on their Mac. My PC is fine, it runs the large majority of the rips and stuff that I use, but I'm just not as fast with it. The keyboard shortcuts, they are not innate like they are for me on the Mac. So I'm super excited for this. So a couple of things, if you guys are interested in now adding a Roland, or upgrading, I'm going to put in the description below my favorite bundles for you so you can grab them. I have other tutorials on both the BN2 and the BN 20. The machines are very similar as far as what they can do. This is obviously the newer model. It does have faster speed and a whole bunch of upgraded features, but they both will work for Mac. You do have to install, as I said, VersaWorks 7, which is the most recent version of the software, in order to unlock that Mac stuff. Also, if you're looking for a little tool, it's a free tool so that you can price your stickers that you make with either of your Roland's for free. Cost calculator, I've got that too. I'm gonna link to that in the description below. If you're looking for customer support, if you're looking for same day support, one-on-one chat, personalized help, I do offer that. Don't be confused, it is offered through Silhouette U, but I do offer that, and we have lots of Roland users as members. So I will link to Silhouette U in the description below. The code YouTube will get you 50% off your first membership. All right guys, see you soon.